Morning, students. I am Dr. Tej Singh, Galgotia's University School of Finance and Commerce. Today, for the discussion, I have taken the subject of CRM, that is Customer Relationship Management, under which we'll take components of CRM today for discussion. The prerequisites for this video PPT today for this discussion is that those students who are pursuing graduation in commerce and business administration are eligible to get this video, and those who have basic knowledge of economic system and market system, then they go for this video. The objectives of the CRM for today's discussion is that to gain knowledge about the CRM, what is exactly the CRM is, what are the components, that is 9 critical components, what are those, what are their meanings, what are their significance, that we will study and discuss how it can be the benefit for higher education and why CRM is so critical to sustainable success. Work through some practical and real life example we'll discuss here. The introduction of the customer. You know that customer is a god, customer is a king today in the market, because the every activity of the business is surrounded towards the customer focus. So it is very important to keep our customer happy, satisfied and retained with your organization. So a customer is the most important visitor on our premises. He is not dependent on us. We are dependent on him, because you know, whole activities, employees and resources we have collected to satisfy the customer's need through providing goods and services. That is why we are dependent on the customers. He is not an interruption on our work. He is the purpose of it. See, we all are doing for the customers. So that is the purpose. He is not an outsider, but he is the part of our organizations. Because we need the feedback, we need problems, we take issues from the customers, and we also survey with the customers for our betterment of the products and services. So that is why it is not a outsider, he is a part of the organizations. We are not doing a favor by serving him, he is doing us favor by giving us an opportunity to do so. Customer understanding is very important, that why customer buy, when customer buy, how customer things to buy, and these all processes a businessman has to understand about that. Then only we can frame a good customer management relationship with them, and we can frame a marketing strategy with them. The consumer is stronger now with the confidence from customer protection laws and regulation of the government, and media also protect them. So the rules are, backing to the customers and protecting to the customers, and the benefits of the customer should not be hampered. These above factors are forcing to go for customer relationship management by the organization much. Now, components of CRM. Before going to the components, we'll see the background of that. The management decides to reduce the hours of the help desk for their information technology services. What are the key drivers behind the decision are as follows: corporatization, centralization, users of service must accept the corporate direction, cost containment is prioritized over performance. Means that customer whosoever having problem and contact to the organization, they must follow the direction of the corporate sectors, these business houses, and plus they should also bear a minimum cost also. so that they need performance and they need that their problems get resolved within no time. Transform common services. If consumers of service are unhappy, they will leave. They will switch over to another competitor's products. Performance is prioritized over cost containment. If your organization is not focused on the customer, then ultimately all negative things will happen to the organization and the organization may go for shut also. So do not have transformed common services with the customers. If you don't have, will not have transformation for a long time, you are not in touch with the customers, then they will assume that okay, no one is taking care of them, so they will switch over to another. So these kind of negative things will happen. Sales will will reduce drastically, and your profit will also go down, and your operating expenses will go high. So in that way, all consequences, negative consequences, will be happening this way. So we have to be in touch with the customers. Now these are the components of CRM. These are the 9 elements we have identified here. So first is account management, client contact management, service partnership agreements, client feedback, continuous improvement, process control database, performance measurement, performance reporting, recharging methodology. So these are very, very important 9 elements of CRM. And all are important to keep the customers happy, and this is the basic strategy of the marketing department of buying organization. So we have to be considered, and one by one we'll brief about that. So first is account management, where account manager has to take these responsibilities. So these are laid down here, one by one I'll brief here. First is responsible for facilitating successful client relationships. So account manager has the responsibility to facilitate customers about the facilities of the organizations, about the problems faced by the customers, and all the process step by step the account manager has to deliver to the customers. Second is client account manager has internal clients. Key interface and internal escalation point between portfolios, branches, programs, that is customers and CSO, common service organizations, act as the account manager, voice of the customer, help establish and manage customer interaction, agreement, interaction structure, implementation, governance and reporting. You see, there is a computerized system or MIS, you can say, management information system, that customer comes, see about the issues, problems, and they feed customer care cell, they feed the problems, and this problems, whosoever is going to resolve, is delivered automatically through transformation process, through MIS system, and get resolved also. And the customer care itself, they say about the feedback, okay, within 2 hours or within 1 day or 2 days, with the minimum cost, you can get your problem resolved. So next is, plays a key role in helping defining service delivery, expectations on behalf of the customers. Engage with customers to improve upstream process performance. You have to be keep in touch with the customers to improve your performance also. Step by step, what are the process of getting problem resolved? So each step must be properly monitored and it should be improved also, so that customers should not feel that okay, a lot of time is being taken by resolving this issue. So it's important. Foster dialogue with fact-based analysis. Reporting with the customer to collaborate and drive process improvement supports process and services harmonization, consistent with the agreed process standard. The next is customer contact management. A customer interaction and transaction structure to facilitate higher level of service response and process efficiency. Requests may be transactional, informational, query process must be flexible enough to accommodate each request. So none of the customers should go without resolving the issue. That should be the priority of the organization. Type and each contact channel, like, you know, customer sale to phone also, through email also we converse with the customers, through a meeting also, or conversation we do with physical or indirectly. There are ways where we contact with the customers and to get the problem resolved and to take and identify the problems with the customer also. Because after sales services through which we follow the customers and we ask to the customers whether he or she is satisfied with the products they are using or they are, you know, having any issues with that. So that must be, you know, feedback also we should take, and that the problem can also be identified through these kind of communication we do. Each request must be captured, routed, acted upon, monitored and resolved. This should be enabled through case management software, if possible, a structured telephone solutions that is MIS, Management Information System, and Customer Relationship Management also. They have, you know, like BPO sectors have a very customized that step-by-step process is there, and issue is goes to the concerned person and that resolve the problem of the customers, and this is the mechanism, electronic mechanism is there. Now next is service partnership agreement. The service partnership agreement is an agreement between CXO and the customer. What are those? It is a two-way agreement, recognizing that this is a partnership identifies the services to be provided by the CXO to its customers, identifies the input that are required from the customers to allow the CXO to provide its services. Suppose, for example, they'll ask you what is your identity, what is customer identity, what is the registration number, the date, the information, date of birth, name, etc. as well. And these, you know, related information they'll ask about that, whether the right customer is approaching or not. Allocates responsibilities for service delivery between the CSU and the person. Defines the appropriate level of service to meet customer needs. The rationale behind service partnership agreement is clarifies the relationship and expectation between CSU and its customers, provide a framework for performance measurement and process improvement, increases the CSO and customer understanding and response to customer needs. See, if we are solving the problem of the customers, then ultimately customer is going to satisfy and happy with the products and the services we are delivering to them. And that is why understanding is building, and, you know, satisfaction is also, you know, by giving by the organization that, you know, they are solving the problems. So that is there. So performance also get into touch, okay, that what are the processes we have involved to resolve that problem of the customers. Then what is the time limit we have given, and within that period of given time we have resolved that problem of the customers. So that is, you know, the performance is there. So good performance, each point, each process is, you know, monitored well, and, you know, problem is being resolved within time. So that is, that makes the customers happy. The next is customer feedback. So we have divided this into two parts, that potentially better and potentially worse. So better I'll take first, because, you know, if you resolving the customer issue, that is going to reduce the cost further. The other customers will not give you, issues like before the customers gave. And there must be a little bit reduction in the same problem. If it occurs, then it is not good for the organization. So that is why the cost reduction is there. A standardized process is there. When you do the process for the various problems, then process itself get improved by the refinement of that process, continuous process. Already, if you have resolved the issues, then ultimately all the chaps, all the points, all the process step by step where the problem is to be resolved, then all are refined in that way. So none of the error will occur further. So that is why this is going to standardize. Controllership, common system, consistent process metrics, accessibility and quality of information, customer service management, quality in the process, where you keep the data of the customers properly updated, and quality in process also, that I told you that in each step you are analyzing, monitoring the issue of the customer. So where it is, become ideal, where it is, delayed, that should be monitored, and this is why the quality in the process is built up. So the worst area is that slow response, recovery, inflexibility, risk of business, working for shared services, that some of the steps are being taken by other organizations, other departments, other companies, then your work or steps or process hamper. Lost decision rights, you don't have decision, then also you are promising to the customers, it's not good. Additional bureaucracy, disconnection from the business, lack of local personal support, local desire to touch everything. So this is the worst, we should not go on that. The next is continuous improvement. That concept is introduced in Japan with the name of Kaizen. Kaizen means that continuous improvement, where you have input, process and output. And as input, we know that various raw materials, various premises, plant, machinery, equipment, people, we need to process the goods. And in process, in plant, we have a lot of facilities to prepare the goods. And as output, we know as profit, as sales volume, as customer, number of customers we have, the market share we have, output, we know that. So each step needs improvement continuously. So it builds the benchmark, it gives you the good quality standards, and you can set for others competitors also, you can lead the market. So in this video, I would like to say about customer relationship management. Now let's type this. If you see various aspects in customer relationship management, that if you do that, your graph will go high like that. You see in this picture. As you know that customers are increasing day by day, warning, confusion, database you are maintaining, lot of different folders you are maintaining, hard copy you are maintaining. So it's not easy to get confused, because lot of complexity is there. Lot of consumers, lot of complexities, lot of difficulties you may face. So little in this video you will see. The database we have to prepare for all customers for a particular product, and there should be a one database that was suggested here. So as we know that customer is the king, is the god, so we all activities we create. So single database must be there, that was suggested, and research on customer needs, that what customer actually want, how we can communicate with the proper to identify the needs of the customers, and we can fulfill also. Because until unless we don't know the need of the customer, we cannot fulfill. We should do meetings with the customers properly. We take orders accordingly. And we have to serve with that. Your business environment should also be considered. So effective planning is needed to maintain the customer happy. Easy communication must be there. WhatsApp facility should be there with the customers also. So conversation should not be disconnected with the customers. See, messages, contracts, meetings we should do with the customers properly. Instructions, whatever you want to give, give clear instructions to them to resolve that issue. So in this way, we should consider these, you know, in this video we have seen. So various database we have to prepare in a folder, in a, you know, manual also, in electronic mode also, so that as soon as you get the punch on that number, you get all details of the customer and it should be updated regularly. So that's all now. Now in process control database, a CRM database is the data organization software that powers the data storage and organization capabilities of a CRM system. It is the heart of CRM system. You will often see the two terms being used interchangeably. The sales team members can access all data at all times. Also being connected with the cloud all allows them to leverage the sophisticated features and the inherent safety of the cloud computing. After a successful marketing campaign, the lead turned into a paying customer and its record in the database is updated accordingly. So these are small elements where we include in that database is personal details, leads sources, customer interaction record, purchase records and other useful information, that how much products you have purchased, variety of goods you have purchased, updated personal details, the place where you live, the place you deliver your goods, various and customer interaction record also, how many times you approached the customer's care cell and how much you know time you have given the issues in that way. It's all record data. How much, you know, useful information also they must have. They may know also the network also, that where are the members in the family of the customers they have. So the proper data they must have. So these kind of process control database we should prepare in this component of CRM. Now performance measurement. Whatever you have delivered will show in the performance as reply on Stratum to present your customer data in performance scorecard that features key metrics like these. Lifetime revenue contribution means that the same customers who have get resolved their problems, are they getting again and again that products or not, they are buying or not. So this is the identification that they are satisfied with your complaint you have done, you have resolved. They have done the complaint and you have resolved. So this way the revenue will increase, discount impact, net profitability is increasing, total profitability, the customer is not paying to other, but they are taking your profit, your product. So in that way profit is going to buy. Customer performance by month, okay, 1 week wise also you can see, month wise you can see that, okay, your sales is going to increase, your customers are going to increase, number of customers are increasing. So in that way you can say the channel profitability is increasing. Customer trends is also, number of customers day by day it is increasing. So you can say that your customer sale is also good, your customer relationship management and system is also doing good. So in that way, customer is not going to switch over to your competitor's course. So that should be the ensure. Next is performance reporting and recharging methodology. Under this, we have performance commentary, that is achievement, past period, whatever the achievements you have in the past, initiative, next period also. You can plan for the next, what you have to want to achieve in the next. Other commentary like main risk issues, process improvement activities we should consider. As performance indicators, we know that service performance indicators, that customer performance indicators, that whatever customers, you have resolved, you have taken their 2000 complaint and you have resolved 1800, 200 are left. So that 200 hours, organization should consider well, and they should pay the time on that to resolve that issue. So why 200 left? So customer performance indicators, selection of internal performance measures, root cause and effect analysis should be there. Okay, where the problem arises, why the problem arises, how many times same problem will arise again and again, and customer will complain you. So that should be resolved. Appendix topics, process improvement, ad hoc service delivered, risk and issues, service incidents, backlogs. How much complaints are in backlog? That should be resolved in time. How much time you have promised to the customer to resolve their problem should be considered and should be monitored also. And recharging customers to become the client now. That every time, this is the main purpose of the CRM, is that customer should be, become a client.